Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of decimals. In this video, we go over the beginning of decimal notation and place value, and we do the following problems. We're going to be working with decimals now, so we're going to start off with decimal notation and place value. So you already know about whole number place value. Remember, we had the 1, the 10, the 100, the thousands place, etc. Notice that to get the next number to the right, you would just multiply by 10. So if you had 1, the next place value, you multiply by 10. Then if you multiply the 10 times 10, you're going to get 100. And if you multiply that by 10, 100 times 10, you'll get 1,000. So decimal notation is a base 10 system. In other words, you multiply by 10 to get the next place value to the left. Now let's go the other way. What if you were over here at 1,000? How would I get the next place value to the right? How would I get from 100, 1,000 to 100? You end up dividing 1,000 by 10 to get to 100. And you divide 100 by 10, you'll get 10. And if you divide 10 by 10, you'll get to 1. So if we kept going, what would this next place value be over here? If I take 1 and divide by 10, one way of writing 1 by 10 is a fraction, 1 divided by 10. This is actually the 1/10th place. When you're working with decimals, it's a special way of writing certain kinds of fractions. So we have to really already understand fractions for decimals to really make sense. All right, so let's say I wanted to get the next place value over. I would divide that by 10. That's a little bit tricky writing 1/10 divided by 10, but let's see, how could I do that? 1/10 divided by 10 is 1/10 times 1 over 10, which is 1/100. So this next place value is going to be 1 over 100. And the next one's going to be 1 over 1,000, same reasoning. And the next one is going to be 1 over 10,000, etc. All right, if we have a number like 45.3, basically there's a whole number part. That's the part before the decimal, which would be 45. And then there's this number after the decimal, and there's a 3 after it. So, first of all, notice the place values again for the parts after the decimal point. Notice the first one is 1/10, the second place is 1/100, the third place is 1,000. One easy way to remember these is it's a fraction, and if it's one place after the decimal point, there's one zero in the denominator. 10, right, is in the denominator. Two places after the decimal point, there's one with two zeros in the denominator. Three places after the decimal point, there's a one with three zeros after the decimal point. So we've got this example, 45.3. That's how a lot of us read this number. But actually, the whole number part is 45. And the fractional part, what we could say is, well, if that three, since it's one place after the decimal point, see if I were going to write it up here. Three is in the 10th place. That's really just 45 and 3/10. Before doing some more like this, let's just work on some problems that only have digits after their decimal point. So they're going to be numbers between 0 and 1. So here are a few problems to get started. We want to write the number as a fraction and then write it in words. So all of these only have one digit that's not a 0. So that's what really is important here. So what is this number here, 0.04? Well, we've got a 4, and what place value is that in? It's 4 something. Well, it's two places after the decimal point, so it's 4/100. Now, I know that could be reduced, but I'm not going to worry about reducing it right now. Let's write this in words. How would you say this? You would say 4/100. Oops. Now you don't want to say four hundreds, you have to remember to put TH, four hundredths. Okay, four hundredths. It's telling you it's less than one. Okay, let's do the next one. Try it on your own. See if you could write it as a fraction, and then how would you write it in words? Okay, so we've only got one digit, the three. And let's see, it's going to be a one with how many zeros after it? Well, the three is in the third place after the decimal, so it's with three zeros after the one. What number is that? Three thousandths. So I would just say three thousandths. All right, how about this next one? Only have a seven. And there's only one place after the decimal point, right? So it's over 10, 7/10. That's all you write, 7/10. So notice in all of these, you always have to put the THS after it. Tenths, hundredths, thousandths, etc. Don't confuse that with 10, 100, and 1,000. Now, when you have a number in front of the decimal point, that will be the whole number part, and then there's a decimal point, and then there will be a decimal or fractional part after that. That's the one between 0 and 1. In the middle, where the decimal point is, we're always going to read that as the word and. So let's see how we would write this. We want to write this number, 102.04, as a mixed number and in words. All right, so what we do is we separate out the whole number part, that's before the decimal. Well, that's 102, so we write 102. If you remember when we did place values with whole numbers, we don't use the word and because this is when we finally get to use the word and. If there's a whole number part and a decimal part, and here it comes, and that breaks up the decimal part. Now we look at the part after the decimal point, right here. Okay, and the number is 4, that's all we see, right? We have to decide where right, let's do this problem. Write 102.04 as a mixed number without reducing the fractional part, and in words. So let's write it as a mixed number. Well, we have the part before the decimal point, and we have the part after the decimal point. So the part before is just that number itself, 102, so you simply write that out. And what about the part afterwards? Well, 0.04, so we've got a 4, and we just have to decide what the fractional part is. It's two places after the decimal, so it's a 1 with two zeros. So that's how I write this as a mixed number. And yes, I know it can be reduced. Now, how are we going to write that in words? Well, you can see it right here. 102 is the whole part, right? But here's the point. There was an and where that decimal point is. That's where we put and. When we did place values with whole numbers, we did not use the word and because it's used when you have a mixed number like this, a whole part and a fractional part or decimal part. So we have 102 and notice in this fraction you can see it's 4/100. Okay. But you should also be able to do that without writing the fraction part first. You look at this and say, well, 4 is in the hundredths place, so you could write and 4/100. So let's try another one like that. All right, so try this one on your own. You want to write it as a mixed number, and you also want to write it in words. Okay, so remember the decimal point is that separates the whole number part from the fractional part. So the whole number part is 20. This time I'm going to write it in words first. Okay, so 20. Then we see a decimal point, right? Remember what that means? And then we have the part after the 20, which is 7, right? Then I have to decide what place value that's in. Well, it's one, two, three places after the decimal point. So think about one with three zeros. What would that stand for? That would stand for 1,000. So this will be thousandths. Now let's write that as a mixed number. Okay, the whole part is 20. So you write 20. And then after the decimal point is 7, so that's the numerator. And then you would say, oh, there's three places after the decimal point, so it's one with three zeros afterwards. 20 and 7 thousandths. So this number, 20.007, means 20 and 7 thousandths. It's actually best to say it this way, although a lot of us are lazy and we say 20.007. But if you read it this way, 20 and 7 thousandths, it sort of drives in home that this is really just a fraction, right? This 0.007. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.